Hello friends, in the previous session we have seen how to generate a voltage from a coil, and we went through the concept of a slip ring and how we found out that in the armature windings the voltage generated is always an AC voltage. So what we have seen in the last class can be summarized in this particular drawing here, where we started the position 1 and we gradually move to position 2 and we rotate to position 3 and position 4. And finally, we get into a graph which looks like this, alright? So if I start at say 0 degree mechanical, okay, for every 90 degree, I have plotted this graph. So this will be 90 degree mechanical and this would be 180 degree mechanical. This would be 270 degree mechanical. So these are all mechanical degrees. And finally, what we get is we reach to our position where you have covered 360 degree mechanical. So in the last class I have told you I will be discussing a particular constructional device which will help us to convert this AC which we have got out of the armature into direct current, direct voltage across the brushes. So let us dive into this particular session by looking what is the device. Now, how to convert the AC voltage in the armature windings into DC across the brushes? Well, the answer is a device called a commutator, or it is also called as a split ring. The split ring comes from the construction. So let us see what is this device. So this particular device which I have drawn here, these two semicircle shaped structures are the commutators. So these are actually made up of hard drawn copper. I will be explaining more about the construction when we go to the construction of DC machine. These are just concepts which you need to understand the basic working of a DC generator. Alright. So here again I have the coil, same coil ABCD. The flux is from north to south. So everywhere the flux is going to be from the north to south, and this is the direction of the flux. We are going to rotate in the same direction, and therefore V at this point will be like this. These are the V vectors, and here V will be like this because we are going for a clockwise rotation. Okay, so again, you know, what does Faraday's law need? Faraday's law needs a conductor, it needs a field, and it needs a relative motion, and we are going to give everything in this particular explanation. So we have the conductors, we have the field, and we are going to provide this rotation, the prime mover torque, to rotate this particular coil. Okay, now let us look at this drawing in two dimensions as we always do. So this is north and south, okay, and look at my conductors here. They are having something called the split ring here. So these are the brushes, okay, these are the brushes, and here is my coil which is like this. And so this is my conductor AB and this is my conductor CD. Now at this point, you know that, like similarly how you have seen in the last case, the velocity is in this direction and the field is also in this direction. So this is the velocity and field, and for this conductor the velocity is in this direction and the field is in this direction. Therefore the induced EMF will be zero, because the value of E is equal to BLV sine theta, and theta is zero in this case, and therefore you will not be getting any EMF. Therefore in this particular case the EMF induced will be equal to zero. The voltmeter here will show zero deflection. Now let us see what happens. Now the conductor is in parallel with the field. The conductor plane is in parallel with the field direction. Therefore the conductor AB will be like this. This is the south, and this is the conductor CD which is in the north, and this is V, and this is V for AB. So V cross B, and all the stories will come here now. So V cross B, you take V and cross with B, therefore you will get an outward EMF. Therefore this will have a dot and this will have a cross. Therefore dot, it will be like this, like this, like this. Now look at here, the commutator 1, here, C1, and this is C2. So the C1 starts at this particular position and it rotates and comes and meets with the brush B2. Alright, so the commutator transfers the EMF to B2. And it comes like this, it comes like this. So sign conventions tell me this would be positive, this would be negative. and it would continue its journey. Finally, it will come here like this, and the conductor will complete its path. So you can clearly see positive is connected to positive, negative is connected to negative. So here I will have an EMF BLV. So with my conventions, it will be positive. Okay. Now, let us see the next path here. The next path, again 90 degree rotation I am going to give. I'm going to give a 90 degree rotations. So clearly, this is the commutator 2 and this is the commutator 1. Yeah. So again, the commutator is not in contact with brush B1 and B2, and EMF also induced will be 0. Same as the first position, just the conductors are reversed in positions. So here also your EMF will be 0 and the voltmeter will show 0 deflections. Now finally, look at here. This is commutator 1, this is commutator 2. In the final position, this is north, this is south. This is my conductor AB and this is my conductor CD. And so AB has a velocity vector like this. This is the field vector. CD is like this. So V cross B, I will get a cross, and V cross B, I will get a dot. So here it's like this, like this, like this, like this, like this. So the current will continue. And again, I'm having a positive polarity here. It will continue and it will complete its path. So here again, E is equal to BLV and my voltage is positive. So if I summarize everything in a graph, what I will get is, on my position, and this is the voltage, I get the voltage across the brush to be something like this. Okay, so this is my position 1, alright, this is my position 2, this is my position 3, and this is my position 4, and if I continue the rotation, I will get it something like this. So this is the position number 5. So clearly, in the previous case, we had got a voltage like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So who did the trick here? The trick here was done by the commutator, because you can clearly see in the previous cases, the conductor AB is always connected to the brush B1. Now, in the initial case here, let us see, the conductor AB had a current which was inducing in this direction, and that was getting connected to B1, and that was passing through this particular resistor. But when you come to the next position here, the conductor induces the EMF like this, and that same thing is getting transferred here. Therefore, initially when the direction was supporting a positive thing, now it is coming to a negative thing. But here in this case, let us take the AB conductor. The AB conductor has an EMF induced like this, and that got connected to brush B2, okay, and brush B2 had a positive sign, so this also had a positive sign. Now in the last post, of course, the conductor has seen a reversal of EMF. The conductor has seen a reversal of EMF, but that reversal of EMF has come to the B1, which was already negative in the first case also. I hope you are understanding. So what happens is that the brush B2 is always getting connected with the conductor which is having the same direction. But however, here in this particular position, brush B1 was first connected with an EMF in this direction, downward direction, and afterward it got connected to the conductor with the upward direction. So in the case, even though the reversal is happening in the conductor, what happens is that AB, initially it gets connected to B1, and when the current gets reversed, it gets connected to B2. So therefore, actually the commutator does this intelligently, so that whenever the current gets reversed in a particular conductor, it changes the brush connection also. So in this, let us take this case here, So here CD is having the inward direction, and B1, let us say that B1 is getting the cross and B2 was getting the dot. Okay, so this was contributed by CD and this was contributed by AB. Now when it comes to this particular position, CD will get the outward and AB is getting the inward. So now in this case, AB is connected to the brush B1, so B1 always get the cross, and CD is connected to B2 and B2 gets the dot. So in this case also, B1 is cross and B2 is dot. So the commutator basically serves like a rectifier by changing the alternating quantity inside the armature, inside the coil in this case, into a DC quantity across the brushes. Now, let me remind you, whatever I have drawn here does not even have the remote similarity with what you have see in a DC machine. If you cut open a DC machine, you won't see coils like this. You will have proper fields, you will have proper armatures, and their construction is entirely different from what you have seen. Even the commutators don't look like this, and the brushes, of course, they are not floating in the air like I have shown here. But these drawings help us to explain the concept in a much better fashion. Alright, so I hope you have understood this particular session, in which I was trying to explain to you the armature winding always has an AC current induced, but however, the commutator, by its action, by connecting the conductors to different brushes at different position, they help to actually maintain the same voltage polarity across the brushes. So I hope you have liked this session today, and please like, share and subscribe for more videos like this, and I'll see you in the next lecture. Thank you.